Hello everyone, you're welcome back to Bioscience class. Today is another lecture and we are continuing the study of lipids. So in our last lecture we talked about isoprene units and terpene. So we are continuing the study of lipid biochemistry. Okay, so steroids, we are going to talk about steroids today. Steroids is one of the classifications under lipid. All right, so steroids, they are built from isoprene units, that's their terpenoid. All right, so we talked about isoprene units on our last lecture. So if you don't understand what isoprene units are, or if you don't know what terpenes are, you can check our last video, or you can check the description that I will leave below so that you can get the link over there and go and study the isoprene unit and terpene so that you can get the maximum understanding in the steroid. We are moving on to study steroids, and when we talk about steroids, they are built from isoprene units, that's they belong to the terpenoid lipids. All right, so they are a class under lipids. All right, so when we talk about steroids, they are a class under lipids, and they are made of terpenoids. And terpenes are also made up of isoprene units. So that is the meaning of steroids. That's basically the understanding of steroids. All right, okay, so they are lipids and they contain steroid nucleus. So we are introducing another topic, steroid, and this steroid, they have a specific nucleus that all the components under steroids, all the class under steroids, they are built upon. All right, so they have a steroid nucleus, which is a fused structure with a 3-cyclohexane rings and 1-cyclopentane ring. Okay, so when we check the structure over here, we have the steroid ring nucleus, or the steroid nucleus, or the steroid structure over here, which I said is composed of 3 cyclohexane rings. So this is 1 cyclohexane ring, this is another cyclohexane ring, and this is another cyclohexane ring. Okay, so it's made up of 3 cyclohexane ring and 1 cyclopentane ring. As you can see here, this is a 5 carbon member. All right, so it's not up to 6, so it's a 5 carbon member, so it's a cyclopentane. Okay, so this steroid nucleus is a fused structure with a 3-cyclohexane ring and 1-cyclopentane ring. So this is the structure that all steroid molecules, all biomolecules made up of steroids, they are built on. So the differences in steroids, okay, the differences in steroids compound are as a result of different functional groups and side chains attached to the steroid nucleus. So this steroid nucleus is the basic structure that every steroid must have. Okay, but the difference in steroid that we are going to talk about later is due to the difference in functional groups. So there are functional groups attached to this cyclohexane units as a substituent. Okay, and there are side chains also attached to this group. There is a metal group and other functional group that is attached to this steroid nucleus. So that comes the differences between all those steroids. So we are going to talk about all the steroids, the structures, and the differences in functional groups in the next slide. Okay, so these are the various steroids and their structures. So let's talk about cholesterol. Alright, the first steroid is cholesterol. Okay, so basically this is the structure of cholesterol. So if you've studied isoprene units and terpenes very well, you can identify the number of isoprene units in steroid cholesterol to determine whether it's a monoterpene, a diterpene, a sesquiterpene, a triterpene, tetraterpene, or polyterpene. Alright, so you can determine it yourself and find out. Okay, so this is the structure of cholesterol. So it's made up of the steroid nucleus. So this is the steroid nucleus, as you can see over here. And I said earlier, the differences in steroid is due to the functional groups attached to the ring and the side chains attached to the ring. So as you can see over here, we have cholesterol over here, we have cholesterol ester over here. So this is the side chain of cholesterol, and this is the functional group of cholesterol ester. So we have the functional group. So the differences between these two esters are due to the functional group over here. So we have a hydroxyl functional group, that's OH group over here, and we have an ester linkage over here. So that comes the differences between these two esters. Okay, so let's talk about bowel acid. Okay, so bowel acid or bowel salt is also a steroid. Okay, and it's basically used in the solubility of lipids. Like, it's used in solubilizing what lipid. For example, we have the glycolic acid, basically known as folic acid. So it's used to solubilize what lipids. All right, and this is also theochoric acid. So it's also used in solubilizing what lipids. So the difference in these side chains is the main difference between these two steroids. Okay, so they have the same functional groups, as you can see over here. They have a steroid nucleus, so basically they are steroids. Okay, but the differences between these two steroids is as a result of the difference in the side chain over here. So the side chain here is a functional group of what? An acid. So it's a carboxylic acid, and this is also a sulfuric acid. Okay, so it's having a hydrogen over here, hydrogen over here, so it's an acid. But when the hydrogen is lost, as you can see over here, then it turns to a salt. So that's how we get bowel acid / bowel salt. Okay, so this is the structure of bowel salt or bowel acid over here. So let's also talk about lipoproteins. Okay, and also we have the sex hormones over here. So these are the sex hormones, and this is a lipoprotein. So lipoprotein, they are a soluble and transport form of lipids in the blood. So we will talk about them in our next video. So basically this video we are talking about the general properties of steroids, the types of steroid, the steroid nucleus, the functional group that differentiates between each steroid, and the side chain of each steroid. Okay, so this is sex hormones. We have estrone, we have estradiol, we have estriol. So these are estrogens. Okay, so they are sex hormones, and each have a specific or function that they play in the female reproductive system. Okay, so we'll talk about them into detail in our next video. So if you don't understand the isoprene unit and the terpenes, make sure you watch that video before you watch this steroid. Okay, so because the understanding is a continuous. So if you don't get the understanding of the the isoprene unit and the terpene, you won't be able to get the maximum understanding in this steroid. So basically this is steroid and this is lipoproteins for you. So if you've not watched this channel before, kindly check out his bike science class. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, you like all videos, you share for your friends to benefit from that. If you have any question, you can leave it in the comment section. You attend to it and address all your concerns. Thank you very much for watching this video. Have a nice and a wonderful day. Thank you.